I give the floor to Her Excellency Ms. Nana Oye-Lithur, Minister for Gender, Children and Social Protection of Ghana.
Thank you, Your Excellency. I congratulate you and members of your Bureau on your election and bring you warm greetings from His Excellency John Dramani Mahama, President of Ghana and the people of Ghana. Within the context of human rights and fundamental freedoms, women started our struggle for equality centuries ago. Within the last few decades, we have recognized that gender equality and empowerment is not just a call for our protection and protection of our human rights, but it makes good sustainable development sense. Last year, we took stock of 20 years of advancing women's economic, social, and political rights under the Beijing Declaration and Platform for Action, and also 15 years of implementing the MDGs. For this reason, our empowerment is unfinished business and has been included as goal number 5 of the SDGs. I commend the United Nations for making a standalone goal. Mr. Chair, Africa has made substantial progress towards the achievement of universal primary education, high primary enrollment rates, and improved girls' enrollment. We lead the world in women's representation in national parliaments. Mr. Chair, we are building on this legacy, and Ghana has identified women's empowerment and gender equality as an overarching goal for implementation of our national development strategy. We have integrated the SDGs into our national agenda. Our national women's machinery has been restructured and capacity increased of our line ministries and our institutions. Our president has made history by being the first Ghanaian president to appoint the highest number of women into public office. 20% of our cabinet ministers are women. We need to work harder on increasing numbers of women in parliament, which is 10.9%, and women in local government, which is under 5%. We have a female chief justice, female government statistician, and also the first female brigadier general of our armed forces. We have strengthened our legal and policy framework. So in 2015, we cabinet approved a national gender policy, social protection policy, child and family welfare policy, and a justice for children policy. We have submitted to cabinet for approval an affirmative action bill. Parliament is currently considering an interstate succession bill and a property rights of spouses bill. We have a specialized domestic violence and victim support unit. We have 102 throughout the country of the Ghana Police Service. To strengthen protection of extremely vulnerable populations, we have created 3 gender-based violence response centers in our markets for out-of-school adolescents and market women. At the highest level, our president, our first lady, and 7 other African first ladies launched a campaign to end child marriage on 10th of February 2016. We are coordinating a gender-sensitive social protection program, and under our cash transfer program, 69% of 144,980 household beneficiaries are women. 480 inmates of which camps are also beneficiaries. We have included 6,200 women as beneficiaries of LEAP with children under 2 years. Mr. Chair, under our labor-intensive public works, 60% of beneficiaries are women. Under our microfinance and small loan scheme, 114,697 are women. Our Commission on Human Rights and Administrative Justice has created a web-based reporting system to encourage vulnerable groups like key populations and persons living with HIV to report cases of discrimination and violence. We have achieved gender parity in education. Mr. Chair, in the wake of strengthened legal and policy framework, we will strengthen institutional capacity to promote enforcement of gender-relevant laws. We will build a resilient economic environment to consolidate gains made on poverty reduction. We will work to address social-cultural traditional dynamics of an African society that at times hinder our progress. In this is 2016, Your Excellencies, we now have goal number 5 that we asked for. Now more than ever, let us all unite to continue the gender equality march, inclusiveness and gender empowerment. It is a journey we must end for women. Ghana is committed and we look forward to a robust, sustainably developed world for the benefit of all persons by 2030. I wish you fruitful deliberations for this 60th session of the Commission on the Status of Women. Thank you.
Thank you.
I thank the Minister for Gender, Children and Social Protection of Ghana for her statement.